Uranium, plutonium, and other nuclear materials all emit gamma rays, and instrumentation is readily available to measure and quantify these gamma rays. So at last, we can move from qualitative measurements to quantitative measurements based on the energy of the gamma rays. There are a number of instruments used in detecting gamma radiation, including gas fill detectors, scintillation detectors, semiconductor detectors, and half a dozen other types. Of these, scintillation and semiconductor detectors have the ability to provide gamma energy information, which we use for isotopic identification in addition to gross counts, which we can relate to the amount of a particular isotope. Scintillation and semiconductor detectors are by far and away the most widely used in gamma spectroscopy, but offer a set of challenges of their own. These spectroscopic detectors are much less robust than gas fill detectors. Their range of operations is minuscule compared to gas fill detectors. They tend to have lower efficiencies than gas fill detectors, and it requires a lot more knowledge to draw correct conclusions from their output. However, their ability to measure the energy of gamma rays is so useful that it overshadows all of the other shortcomings. Decaying isotopes produce monoenergetic gamma rays, and this gamma energy and the frequency of gammas at specific energies provide a signature unique to a particular isotope. Other advantages include that spectroscopic detectors can be made portable and used to measure isotopic composition from relative measurements, or to measure the amount of specific isotopes there, absolute measurements. That said, these absolute measurements are difficult at best and impossible at worst. The gamma ray absorption is often significant and must be corrected for. Both energy and efficiency calibrations are usually necessary, and sample geometry can render any measurement useless if the sample is large, dense, or heterogeneous. And many of the samples are exactly that.